Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to Go Guzzle Gone, yet another episode of a podcast because you showered enough love on the previous one. Although you see the familiar faces over here, but today I want you all to focus more on what we represent instead of thinking what we are. We are individual independent women, and today we are here to talk about some serious concerns which we are facing in the society these days, wherein we feel the women's safety has been compromised on various levels. What measures and precautions we can undertake to bring some sort of change in the society. So today I have my younger sister Shreya with us. She is also a researcher with the BHU, and please tell us a little more about yourself.
So I'm basically pursuing my PhD from Banaras Hindu University, and I'm doing my PhD in zoology. So I'm into like a woman in STEM.
Unique field.
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah.
So how is life in BHU?
If you talk about the university and research, it's very nice because it's in top 5 university, so it's pretty nice, and it's actually being funded very nicely by government. The government is being generous to us. So
yeah. And especially your sector, I feel you guys get a chance to go and explore international conferences and make some networks with new sort of scientists
as
well.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, we are blessed with that. But when you talk about like, because BHU is in Banaras, in Varanasi, a pretty small town.
Very small town.
It has its separate challenges when you live there, and especially if you, like I did my graduation and post-graduation from Delhi. So it was all a cultural shift from Delhi to Banaras.
That's a huge shift.
Yeah, that's a huge shift. And
but do you also believe that the mindset is a choice? It's a conscious choice you adapt to.
Yeah, true.
It doesn't matter really if you come from a big city or from a smaller city.
Yeah, I think the only difference it makes is like in the majority.
Mm-hmm.
Like in small towns, like if you see the perspective or these kind of things are in the majority, but it is in the big cities as well. But
absolutely,
it's very rare to see and to witness it. But I think in small towns, it's very generalized, it's normalized, these kind of things. And I,
but that's kind of very, very creepy, huh?
It's very creepy. It's very creepy because, and also I've noticed, like, because I live in both the places.
Exactly.
So I have seen these few differences. Like, victim blaming is pretty common in small towns.
Yeah.
When you see, and like, the girls are not very vocal about it in small cities.
Do you think the smaller the city is, the family members are more protective towards their kids because they're more scared? What if this kind of channelized out in the society and the networking is so strong because you are in a confined city space? So you think that the girls who come from a smaller city are being suppressed to vocalize their opinion?
Yeah, that's true, because wahan pe ek ghar ki izzat jo ki I don't know how it is,
but that's more important than anything,
how it is attached to the women of the family.
Yeah,
wo cheez wo dhakne ke liye wo constrain karte hain bahut sari opportunities. Like bahut sare aise hum dekhte hain ki government schools mein, because we all know private schools are pretty much better and give you pretty much exposure than government schools. So what they do is, when you see कि small towns या villages में वो अपने घर की लड़कियों को भेजते हैं government schools to save money to educate their sons in private schools.
So
कहने को वो बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ चल रहा है, but you can clearly see how the opportunity is taken away from them.
Actually, I've got so many examples also in my head wherein people are not out loud about it, but you can see the differences in their mentality. They think that the boy of a family would be the one who would take the education forward and the family forward. And you instead, because somehow they know that at the back of their head that eventually you will get married,
yeah,
and become a daughter to somebody else.
You don't carry their generation forward.
Yeah.
That is what they think about you.
Yeah.
And us may be like, even if they educate their daughters and everything, in their mind, the ultimate goal is marriage.
Totally.
And they don't feel that, like, okay, she could have been let into some other thing or some ambitions or different kind of field. It's very rare.
But eventually, in last few months, we have seen that so many massive incidences has been documented, which is very unfortunate that our society had to go through it. But you feel when such incidences takes place, we go 30 years backwards by miles.
That's true. That's true.
It affects
a lot. Because I feel like small towns here, small villages, when you see, they are already scared to let the women of their family go out of the city and get some education or on exposure. And after this incident, they are pretty scared. And the people who don't even want to, now they have a reason.
Yeah.
That they will not let them.
And also I feel the younger generation, which is going to be an apparent future of our country as an overall, also gets suppressed, because maybe, see, especially in a society like India, I feel that they already have very limited career option, not just for females but also for males, right? Because they don't want to explore something new out there, which we spoke about in our previous podcast clearly. And even you are doing something which is very unique. It is a very exclusive field. People have not known about this field. And especially in this era when people are running out of patience, PhD is a professional
prime, and you're in the prime age, it's all into studies.
I mean, I see your hard work and how much sacrifice you do. Even us catching up at times becomes difficult because us putting up in two different sort of places, like, you know, we have to really make a strong effort to be there with each other, right? You feel these girls who are about to choose profession like me and you are also gonna get challenged because of these kind of incidences?
That's true, because both of our lines, like professions, they require very different, and they require to live alone, to live independently, to live out, it could be like out of the country as well. And now the people, their family, they are scared to leave them alone. They are scared how many people they will meet, what would be the hours they would be working. Like I sometimes work 12 to 14 hours. You work at odd hours.
Pretty much.
From night to morning or something like that.
Totally.
And now, they will not allow them. They will be scared, like, because the incidents that happened, it was on the night shift recently that happened. So that is how it's affecting, and that is how it will affect. So it will obviously take us back to 30 years, but I hope it should have taken us to around 5,000 years back, when the war of Mahabharat came to place because of some women, because of a woman.
But you know, the thing I feel is this mentality wherein all the responsibilities are being declared on a woman has to be given a thought. Especially victim blaming is pretty common in our society.
So common. And it hurts when you see coming from a woman itself.
Because they think it's normal.
Yeah.
And that's an insane part about it.
Yeah, because the first question, and nowadays, like previously what I heard, the first question after these kind of incidents were, what was she wearing? Why was she doing, what was she doing it late at night? Why was she traveling in the bus? Why was she using that and everything?
Or why is she in relationship with somebody?
Why was she with a boyfriend? And now what I hear, and which is very very depressing that I hear nowadays, is what was her religion? What was her
caste? Are you serious?
That's the question you hear.
How does that even matter?
Exactly. And it's a heinous crime. You cannot give itself a credit to some other topic. It's not about religion, it's not about caste. It's a heinous crime against a woman. So I think people, they are diverting from the main issue. Like, what is this?
I feel also there are a lot of propagandas which is being involved to kind of distract you and not talk about it as much it should be spoken about.
That's true.
I didn't hear, it was raging on social media when the incident took place, and soon after one, the other one came up, and then these are the documented incidents, because it has a massive impact on a society, so people are sharing it out. How about incidences which takes place
that we normalize? The eve-teasing, the harassment, the comments that
exactly.
we hear, the unknown touches that we face when we go out in the market to buy vegetables or something. we have been through that. I mean, wherever we go on streets, yes, to do shopping, we have been touched in it. And sometimes we also don't even know. Like, because we feel, okay, there's a rush, somebody's
accidentally might have happened. Yes.
Exactly. But when you feel, you can feel that type of touch.
Absolutely.
And you feel so...
And you just know it.
Yeah. And you know, and sometimes you also know, okay, this might be the person who did that. You feel it. And this is what happens, that you feel dirty.
You feel disgusted.
You feel disgusted. And you just want to take a shower. And that is how it happens. Even sometimes when people see you with their eyes only, and you are like, okay, I want to take a shower now. I feel disgusted just by their looks.
Exactly.
So, and this is, and I think men cannot even feel that. How stressed we are 24/7.
True. We are on, like you always say, we are always on alert.
Yeah, always on alert mode. And that is why we are tired as women.
Yeah.
We are always tired because we are not even safe when we go to some relatives, when we go to family meetings. We are not safe there as well.
That is another issue altogether. Sure. Like we were talking about suppressing a voice of a female.
Hmm.
It is so crazy on so many levels, and I feel in all the field, especially, okay, I don't live in India as much as you do. What are your challenges in your field? Because very less has been spoken about your field. Would you like to share any of your experiences? What kind of, because you work with very educated and literate people.
I would call them literate people, not educated, because everybody is not educated. Everybody is literate in our field, but not everybody is educated.
Here we are talking about,
yeah,
like,
everybody, because I have heard victim blaming in my field as well.
No way.
I've heard victim blaming, and it's very sad from a woman, from the women community. Wow. I've heard victim blaming. I have seen superior males, and I have heard the stories of males taking advantages of their skills by exploiting women. Like, if you're gonna talk very nicely, you know, the way they want, then only they're gonna guide you, then only they're gonna teach their sharing and skills, and then only they will teach you something. This is what happens in our
favors and favoritism.
Exactly. And it's pretty disgusting out there, and like, we have to work sometimes night shifts in
our absolutely field.
And now we all feel scared. We all feel scared because sometimes, like, I have to do, because it's my profession, it's my
absolutely
job. And if a colleague of mine who is of an opposite gender has to stay as well in the night for his job, I think I would be the one who would be stopped doing it. Like, you know, you come in the morning and you do your shift.
Just you feel you, because of this, you miss out on opportunities.
Of course, like, what if my experiment is also important, right? Like, we both are there. Sometimes you're not, like, in an interview, they will reject you because you're a woman. Why? Because you will not be able to do night shifts. They will be like, no, we cannot take risk. We cannot take risk. Like, they will blame it on your safety, on your gender. We don't want to take any risk. You cannot do night shifts.
But my question is, why there is a risk?
Exactly. Why there's no precaution?
Why somebody has to take a responsibility of your safety?
Hmm.
See, why they're running away, the bottom line is this, because they would be blamed for your safety.
Yes.
So you're telling me that the safety is something which can be compromised on so many levels.
They make it as a privilege to us. You know, this is happening and this is that. So safety is a privilege to us. We should be thankful that we are safe. We should be thankful there are CCTV cameras. These are the things, like when the unfortunate incident happened in Kolkata, and everybody was like, oh, thank God we have CCTVs in the building. This is the first thought they had.
I mean, you see how people...
It is generalized. It's so normalized.
And also I saw that a lot of people were trying to milk out views from such incidents by materializing everything out there.
Exactly.
I mean,
and next day I'm posting again on the objectification of women. They think it's funny. Before that, they were also doing that, promoting explicit pages, promoting all kind of women-based jokes and everything. They don't know this. These are the few things that give rise to these kind of crimes. Because that said, like, how women are always disregarded of their positions, how they are always degraded, how they're always disrespected. They're made fun of for their emotional
and
skills.
And it's really funny, you know, when this incident took place, I don't know if you're aware about it or not, there was some guy on Twitter. He posted that what is as a dark
humor. Okay, yeah, I saw that. It was disgusting. it was disgusting.
That, why are you doing it to a person who is not even beautiful or something like that? I mean, is it supposed to be funny? Where is your
not dark humor? This is not dark humor. Dark humor.
I mean, he was trying to portray it out as a dark humor.
Yeah, yeah.
But then I don't find it funny.
Yeah, and then these people are like, oh, nowadays people don't get humor. This is
no, humor. This is pure not humor.
Because people are not raising their voice against this so-called body shaming jokes or these kind of things. You cannot do these things.
And the severity of the situation is that it is happening at a public place, right?
Exactly.
At a workplace.
That is
and two major aspects of any humans who are living and surviving on, who is independent and going to work.
Exactly.
So you're telling me that we are not even safe at our workplace.
And you know, I think from our 24 hours of a day, we spend most of the time at our workplace.
At our workplace, all of us.
Not at home.
All of us.
Because we go have dinner, sleep, and then we go to our workplace. And we spend most of the time there. And just imagine we are not even safe there.
Exactly. I mean, that's concerning.
Yeah. And that is why like people would be like, you know, don't do work after, you know, these kind of people.
But again, when you talk like that, I feel, again, it's a lack, maybe I want to work.
They are allowing and disallowing you.
I mean, it's my right to, okay, like you work on your experiments for days and days and days. There could be a time wherein you really want to go and rush to your place in odd hours.
Exactly.
Maybe there's an emergency or you want to set up something right or you just kind of
remember
something. This is not going to turn out right. But you can't do that.
You cannot do that. And again, I have to do it all over again. Start all over again because of that issue. Like, we have been told that if you want to do long shifts of work, come at 5 a.m. in the morning, because if you have to work 12 to 14 hours,
I know
what
you mean.
Till 6 to 7 p.m. So like, what if I'm a night owl? What if I want to work at night? I don't want to work in the morning.
You can't do that because you are a woman.
Yeah, and like, if I have to work from 5 a.m. and I'm living independently, so I have to cook. I have to get all the house chores done, and because for that I have to wake up at 3 a.m. Like, how could you
this
even...
Is...
You know,
it sounds funny and bizarre, but then
I'm taking it very normally, but it's
very concerning because people have gender, like you said, it's been generalized that ठीक है ये तो अगर तुम लड़की हो तो तुम्हें ऐसे ही रहना है
वो तो कुछ चेंज नहीं हुआ तुम ही चेंज हो जाओ
मतलब I come from like okay चलो you live in India you have an Indian society to work with I work with multicultural society and it is very alarming sometimes because I work as a manager right sometimes I have seen my colleagues literally telling it in front of me I prefer to work with male colleagues
oh god
because they are chill or because they're cool or sometimes they say oh you're so cool when we saw that the woman is gonna be a manager we were concerned that our flight is not gonna go that well
and these things come from a woman's mouth
women and also I have seen people checking that if they have more male customers or more female I was startled to another level when I saw that happening I'm like what are you looking at you know I'm just seeing if I'm going to deal with more drama or less drama a woman is talking about another woman how alarming does that sound
exactly
to you?
And that's how these kind of crimes takes place because as a woman like sometimes like you always see a woman as the starter of something that culturally we are built to right and you are the first one who's going to educate your younger ones
exactly
right because before going to school you are going to educate them so these are the thoughts you will inculcate to them
and I'm talking
this
about youth huh?
This is scary
I work with youth right
true
and this is their thought process
oh my god
And it is so alarming, like that it comes, and I've never heard a male telling me that. Instead, I always like, see, whatever influencing power I have, I try to tell them that never talk like that in front of me. Because it is not right the way you're stereotyping.
Kudos to you, these voicing it out.
I am.
Because I have seen women not voicing it.
I don't know. Have you heard this? It sounds very pathetic. I don't know if you have heard this. She should have got married on time, or else her hormonal changes are making.
They blame it everything on your menstrual cycle. Like, oh, you are angry, or you're getting angry on everything. Or is it your periods are near?
No.
Because you are doing some shit work. That is why I'm angry. Can't I be angry on the logical reasons? Like, they are gonna link everything to your hormones.
Always.
And it provokes you to another level.
No, because it is, you know, and the thing is, they find it very, very normal to make such statements. And I initially used to think that I am the one who's being more sensitive towards it. See, I'm not denying the fact that there's certain women in our community that who take privilege to be a woman. I'm not denying that, right?
Sure.
But again, how can we forget that certain section who want to be individualized, who want to be recognized, and we do not want anything unequally done for us.
Exactly.
I don't want any favors.
You know, have you heard that this thing, like, have you heard this key whenever you get promoted or something? They are always blame you, like, oh, she got promoted. This must be some other reason behind it. In a very dirty way, they say it.
Skilled in a different way. This,
yeah. They will never appreciate your hard work. They will never consider or acknowledge it. They will like, oh, she must have done something to get the promotion. Like, why is it my hard work? Like, how can you sexualize it in a way? Like, couldn't be like, because I worked hard day and night and that's why I got the promotion?
No, they can't believe that. You were also telling me, Nina, that in your school, they were quite stunned to see you as a topper.
Yeah, I didn't know this,
by the way.
Yeah. Because just imagine how sad my birthday parties were because I invited everybody and nobody came. Every year.
Shit, I got goosebumps.
Every year.
When did this happen? Oh my
every
god.
Every year. Because I had no friends. Because
actually, I never
had birthday parties. You always had your birthday. I never had my birthday party. And that is how you... Because I'm not taking advantage of being the victim. I'm not victimizing myself.
Yeah.
I'm okay with it. Because I honestly don't like my circle to comprise of people who are not evolved. And majority of...
That's why we're lonely people.
And majority of kids are not evolved. Like, see, evolved does not mean you have... I hate that mentality when men are sensitive... Human, when they are sensitive towards it and people call them feminine. Have you heard this?
I have felt it also once. Okay.
Like, when you're just sensitive... No, they're not feminine. They just are very comfortable in their masculinity.
Yeah.
They're not insecure. Like, why do you have to be rude to a woman to prove they're masculine?
Or suppressive.
Yeah. They're like, oh, he's very sensitive to
them.
Why do we
have to classify males that he's a very progressive guy? Why?
Exactly.
Every guy has to be progressive. Every guy has to understand that if you are marrying a woman and that woman wants to go out there and make something of her own,
exactly,
we don't need permission from you.
Yeah, like, have you heard these statements? Like, I have heard it from people, that their stories, that they're, whenever they're going to get mad or something and the other party, they're like, I earn now, why you have to do a job and earn, just take care of the family. Like, she's not doing just for money.
Money is a very important part, but
but she's doing it for own satisfaction. They disregard it. Okay, you're just earning it for your financial stability. No, she must enjoy her work. Why can't you take it and accept it? Oh, she also enjoys her work.
I think this concept is subtly shown in this Bollywood movie also, To Jhooti Main Makkar.
Okay. They had
this concept wherein Shraddha is trying to because she's dating this guy from a rich business background, and she still wants to go out and work. And they always keep telling her, and she gets very agitated with it. Like, what the hell? I'm not just going out there to survive and make money. I'm going there to just because I like to be there.
Yeah.
You know?
Because I have seen, because there are my friends who are in corporates, and I have seen and I've heard from them that their colleagues who are like female on a higher position, they don't accept more promotions because they have to change their cities, you know, and their spouses are not working, so they have to deny the promotion. Like, why?
ladki ko hi adjust karna padta hai.
They have to deny promotion just to stay at the same place.
I mean, you know, it is so bizarre that we live in such a patriarchal world एंड आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम्स विद मेन. आई हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ मेल बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स. आई हैव गॉट अन मैरिड सन एंड डीलिंग विद अ गाय. आई हैव फादर, वी हैव कजिन्स. आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट मेल कम्युनिटी, बट माय क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई certain people are brought up with that kind of consciousness wherein they think once they are with a woman they get a right to make decision on their behalf.
They always think they are on a pedestal
and it's just a muscle memory.
Yeah,
like why?
Exactly.
And I hate girls when they are in a dating phase, and I've seen it, they change like 360 degree. Okay, this is just a pure question. When you date a person, okay, eventually you're going to lead it to marriage or maybe breakup, right?
Exactly.
One of the above. So even if you lead it to marriage, you have father, mother, brother, sister. You're going to balance all those equations, right?
True, true.
And he's just an addition to it. Why you have to change yourself entirely to give utmost respect and dedication to this person, and you lose out on all the relationship because he cannot be a brother.
True.
He cannot be a sister or mother.
They can never be.
I have seen my friends changing, like you know, क्या पहनूं, क्या खाऊं, क्या पीऊं. अरे तुम वही करो जो तुम पहले से करते हो.
Exactly. Just do what you're comfortable with. And I think men out there who are very comfortable into their masculinity and everything, kudos to them. And I think women and men both, whenever they hear casual sexism, whenever they hear these kind of jokes around them, they should voice it out.
Yeah.
People fear, because what they fear is, what if I raise my voice and I lose them? I lose the friends. They will not find it cool.
I was about to say, what if they find it? Shit, do I sound uncool?
Yeah. And अगर we voice it out, तो हम लोग को तो pseudo feminism का झंडा पकड़ा दिया
जाता है। भाई, वो तो मतलब मुझे तो ऐसा लगता है कि दुनिया में आधी जनता यही सोचती है कि pseudo feminism is a real. I know there are a lot of players out there who really utilize this concept as a like you know कि चलो अब करते हैं. But here,
but also like feminism is also not that we are trying to uplift and downlift.
We just equalize.
That's it. Like how I really admire Priyanka Chopra, and how she said, like, if a husband could be a CEO and he's okay with it, why if she becomes a CEO and why they reporters have to ask, like, how you're managing both the responsibilities being a mother?
They always do that.
Why?
Yeah.
Like, it's so
they really need to evolve. And you know the question, it's why is that question popping in your head?
Exactly. Why? Like, why you think that it's only a mother's responsibility towards a child?
Even once I remember Kareena also said in her interview when she was pregnant, because she was a flag bearer of
that
pregnant era where she's going out and doing endorsements and working in the movies and still.
She was the most
pregnant. She said, I'm pregnant, I don't have a disease.
That's true.
You know, we need to normalize all these things. But I always feel when such incidences in society takes place, I feel very bad for girls like us who really are working hard to make their career. They're trying to motivate themselves every day.
Because we are trying to swim against the current. And that requires a lot
of
courage.
And this incident, it takes you back.
Yeah.
It becomes an obstacle for you to convince your parents and ensure them that nahi bhai, I will take care of my safety, let me go.
You know, I think recently I have started carrying pepper spray with me. Always.
Achha.
Yeah. I'm also in active mode. Always.
Even when you were coming from a cab, no?
Yeah.
She was about to arrive at 12:30, which is no time basically. It's a very normal time for people like us. And we were still, because our family members, they always sleep. There's a certain regime for them to sleep. But they were taking an extra effort. No, we'll go and pick her up. And they were trying to be awake the whole night. So that
and that is how it affects. That is how
and
it affects.
I think, because we were speculating, that, achha, theek hai, nahi, tum aa jao. Nahi, auto. Then she's like, nahi, main auto lungi. And I know why you said that.
Exactly, because main bata dunga. Secret, and I told my friend and he laughed on it. He was like, what is this logic? Like, every girl has this logic.
I know.
Because we always prefer auto because it's easy to jump. And just imagine, we're okay
how
being
insane.
Injured. It's really easy to jump out there.
but in camp but
you didn't say it, but I knew it. Yeah, because every girl knew it, and boys they don't know it. Okay, but this is the reason. So look at it, why not taking a cab? This is why we don't take a cab.
Yeah.
This is why every girl travels by auto. Even if it's chilly, even if it's raining, auto is okay. At least we'll be safe. And this is how we also have generalized it.
This is so, the thought itself is twisted.
Yeah, and you know what twisted, I think the most twisted, that we also have generalized these things. Like we are like, okay, we have to live it like that. What can we do in this?
I'm getting goosebumps. I swear, no, because you know when this happened, I was still in Doha at that time, and then I see that everybody is posting about it, and everybody is talking. I saw so many stories of yours that we need to voice it out. I was so traumatized because I landed and I just saw all these. I'm like, what is this happening? And when I read it, the more I read,
it was more horrifying.
The more horrified I was getting.
Exactly.
And when I was on the flight also, one of the captain, he showed me, like immediately after this incident, this Air India incident took place, right?
Yeah, that happened.
He had like kind of screen, because it's related to our industry also. So he screenshotted everything, like, Ghazal, see what's happening in your country. I'm like,
oh my God.
And okay, they took place in London, but Air India being the national carrier for India, and they all were talking about it, and I didn't know what to do, what to say.
Yeah.
But you know, when I was doing the briefing for my crew, when we were coming back from one of the, I think we were in Los Angeles at that time, and when we were coming back, I was like, guys, it's no more just a safe flight. Please have a safe layovers. Lock your room, chain your room, because dude,
and now this will become normalized in your field as well.
Yeah,
everyone would be very scared.
Are there were so many other crew members from different airlines. They started naming out destinations.
Oh,
because I have like, you know, relations like that, wherein people were screenshotting the story and they were showing everything. Like, it has happened something similar with me here, and then one of my colleague told me something similar had happened. But the male colleague of there, like in this case, he was not ready to highlight it. Because you're comfortable, but you never thought about the other woman who faced it. See, this is, heroes are not born. You have to become a hero.
That's true. You have to become.
And you know, I feel these are very small, tiny, teeny acts which you can just pull up, and you can, you know, you can raise your standards too high.
Like, sometimes it's okay to let go of those friends who would be toxic for you.
I have let go a lot of them.
Who you feel like, see, I always say this to my male friends, acquaintances, I would say.
Exactly. Always. Friends is like,
it's a very high position that you get in life. But I think for acquaintances, I always say that whenever you sit with a guy, just think about your sister or your girlfriend or your wife or your mother. That would they be comfortable sitting in the same group and talking about these things? Always think about those conversations.
Very well said. Yeah.
And they don't, because why are you cool wala kya hai concept, I don't know. Like, I have heard words in my schools, like whenever I heard from male students as well, they had different terminologies, different codes for different women figures, and they called it out to them. I like that they were not my friend, but they were my classmates. I still regret,
but I think from there it starts.
From there, because they think it's okay to objectify a woman. Okay, if she's very thin, calling her a flat screen TV. I have heard these terminologies, and they feel it's okay to objectify. They think it's okay, like pointing out to all the women body parts out there. Yeah, and I still regret it ki us time pe mere andar itni himmat nahi thi that I
because hum just generations hai, at least main just generations se aati hu. मुझे तो मतलब मैं तो इस बात से परेशान रहा, एक तो मैं बहुत टॉकेटिव हूँ, तो मतलब ब्लैंक कॉल आ रहा है तो मेरी गलती है.
हाँ.
कि मुझे भी पता भी नहीं है कौन कर रहा है,
विक्टिम ब्लेमिंग वही है.
अरे मैंने कुछ खाया पिया कुछ नहीं, ग्लास तोड़ो बाहर आना.
बिकॉज वही मैंने बोला ना, यहाँ पे एक तो ये जो इनकी थिंकिंग रहती है, लाइक अ वुमन व्हेन शी या वी आर ओपनली टॉकिंग अबाउट समथिंग, वी आर ओपन टू एवरीथिंग.
मुझे तो ना शुरू में ये भी बहुत इंश्योर करना पड़ता था क्योंकि मुझे नहीं पता था कि मैं बहुत एक्सट्रोवर्ट हूँ या मैं बहुत मैं तो नॉर्मल हूँ बट शायद लोगों के लिए बहुत ओपन एंड इवन नाउ आई एम लाइक दैट बट दैट आई यूज फॉर टू मेक मनी यू नो इफ यू गुड एट समथिंग जस्ट मेक इट योर प्रोफेशन लाइक यू नो मेक मनी आउट ऑफ इट आई यूज इट फॉर माय मनी थिंग बट नाउ आई फील आई वाज नॉट रॉन्ग बिकॉज आई वाज बीइंग लेमिनेटेड इनटू दिस थॉट प्रोसेस दैट मैं बात करती हूँ तो मैं गलत सिग्नल देती हूँ बट मैं अरे भाई
अरे आई टोल्ड यू ना वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड दैट टोल्ड मी ऑन इंडिपेंडेंस डे वाला थिंग कि व्हेन शी टोल्ड यू नो यू व्हेन
शी आंटी
दैट आंटी दैट यार आंटी हमारे लिए क्या इंडिपेंडेंस एंड शी सेड अरे वो कोलकाता रे केस वाली बहुत बात करती होगी एंड दैट इज हाउ अ वुमन इज थिंकिंग ऑन अनदर वुमन दैट ओके शी मस्ट हैव टॉक सो मच दैट्स व्हाई इट हैपेंड
But does that give somebody else the right
to justify do the such action? A horrific?
Yeah, it's not justified. Though if you read about it, there are so many things on different layers. I don't really.
It's not even a human activity.
Because, yeah,
it's not, you can not categorize like, it as a human activity.
It's like you are possessed, and you know, it's a demonic act.
Exactly. I think even demons are very polite than that. I think. Like you cannot do
no
that.
I mean especially from the culture we come from we our like epics Ramayana exactly. Mahabharata it's all about women but people only do victim blaming inhone ye kiya to Mahabharata hua isne
all ke chakkar mein hi sari ladaiyan
hoti hain and this is what an extract you get from such a great epic
exactly jahan pe kitni cheeze justify me like agar उसका वस्त्र हरण हुआ अगर तो उसके हाथ उखाड़ दिए गए कैन यू इमेजिन द लेवल ऑफ पनिशमेंट
एग्जैक्टली
यहाँ पे एक फांसी की सजा के लिए 10-10 साल वेट कर रहे हैं लोग विक्टिम मतलब विक्टिम का नाम तक आप सब में जस्ट इमेजिन विक्टिम का नाम फोटोग्राफ्स एवरीथिंग वाज सर्कुलेटेड हाउ डिसगस्टिंग एंड कल्प्रिट को आज तक आप पकड़ भी नहीं पाए एंड दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस आप एटलीस्ट कुछ नहीं तो अपने एपिक्स से तो सीख लो
वही तो बात है रिलीजन का नाम लेके मुद्दा उठाना बहुत आसान है
कैन यू इमेजिन लाइक व्हाई इफ यू रिमेंबर द एपिक टेल ऑफ महाभारत शिशुपाल इफ यू रिमेंबर ही क्वेश्चन द फ्रेंडशिप बिटवीन द्रौपदी एंड कृष्णा एंड ही वाज बीहेडेड
यस
सो इट शोस आई लव
दैट सीन आल्सो लाइक इन माय हेड
एंड कैन यू इमेजिन हाउ गॉड पनिशेस व्हेन यू एक्चुअली क्वेश्चन आउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन अ मैन एंड
एग्जैक्टली
And he pointed it out when Shishupal said, "How can a married woman be a friend with a guy?"
Exactly, I've got goosebumps.
Yeah, and अगर 5000 पहले इतनी broad mentality हो सकती है,
it was a matriarchal culture.
And अब क्या हो गया? हमने तो ऐसे बढ़ना था ना, हम ऐसे क्यों बढ़ रहे हैं?
हम उल्टा ही जा रहे हैं.
हम उल्टा जा रहे हैं.
Living in a dark age, I am saying out loud, and with these kind of horrific incidences, I feel we have gone to level higher.
Exactly.
कुछ तो change हुआ है. मतलब तुम ये देखो कि उस टाइम पे हम शिव जी और अगर गौरी माता का एग्जाम्पल भी लेते हैं शी यूज टू फाइट हर ओन बैटल्स
एंड ये शिव जी खुद कहते थे यू नो कि यू
आर तो कर ही
लोगे यू कैपेबल यू नीड मी
व्हाई यू नीड
यू कैपेबल इन अ
फाइट ओन बैटल्स उल्टा इट वाज उल्टा इट वाज ऑलवेज यूज्ड टू बी उल्टा
एग्जैक्टली
एंड दैट्स व्हाई इवन आवर लॉर्ड्स यूज्ड टू गिव देयर नेम्स They wanted the names to be taken first.
Yeah,
Gauri Shankar. Then we have Radha
Krishna. That's true.
Like
we always say Siam.
Yeah, we never say the other way around, right?
Exactly.
So this is how much respect our gods, our ancestors used to give.
And that's what we haven't taught. But I don't know kya inhe sikhaya ja
raha. Acha, ye maine dekha hai na, lack of awareness iska sabse bada root cause hai.
Because they don't read, they just hear from everybody.
एक तो ये जो WhatsApp University चलती है ना,
ये अपने में अलग battle है।
ये अलग ही चल रहा है, like
और
you know,
ये बढ़ता ही जा रहा है।
And you know, I was fuming when we were talking about it. We were fuming that these things should be addressed and to our youth, wherein and we were looking for a right platform to do it, and that's how we decided. कि भाई हम इसपे एक
like what's been enough
enough
to talk about
exactly and that's how we came out loud about it but then it's bizarre the way everything is being handled what do you think what are the measures our society can adopt to deal with women's safety, because it's not even industry specific anymore.
It has now become very broad.
For that matter, even housemakers, how do you know that they are not going through something?
That's true.
What if something is happening behind the curtain?
Exactly. And I've seen and heard stories a lot, and I think that's how trauma comes. I saw a girl, she was being uncomfortable with some older age guy, and I first time this in my life, because I've always been an introvert, and first time in my life I went alone to her, I pulled her hand, I grabbed her with me to a different place, and like, whenever you feel unsafe, come to me. And she was
That's so thankful, sweet.
And she was like, thank you so much, I was very uncomfortable. I'm like, yeah, just come to me, stay with me. Whenever you feel like, whenever you want me, just come with me and sit with me, it's okay. And she was a total stranger. And she was so thankful. I was like, oh, okay, now finally I've got the courage to stand against
And that is
how I think the society should take stand.
And I also feel, like you said, voicing it out. Mm-hmm. Also, if you are not really comfortable, like you said, people have introvert nature. Find a right person and a right place to talk to address it to.
Exactly. Like, I always talk about these things to you or to mom.
Yeah.
I always do that. I was like, okay, this is happening. I don't know what to do. Because sometimes these things happen to very close ones, and you don't know how to react to it.
And it needs to be stopped at the first level.
Exactly.
And you need to cut
it. And that's how you need some advice. Like,
yes.
I always talk to you, ye ho raha hai, what should I do? Because that person is close to our family or something like that. Like, what should be the action? I think those people will guide you.
And adding to that, like, since we are talking about the measures, I also feel that because social media is a new media, right? We all have got platforms to raise our opinion about certain things. There shall be certain regulations to monitor the kind of content which is being put out there.
Oh, that's so true. That's so true.
I mean,
filter
there are, okay, like I was telling about certain incident wherein how to open a hotel room
which
is electrically locked from inside, which can only be opened with the key of that room or from a master key. There's loose videos available on a loose levels.
How to open it.
And it is security issue if you think about
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
How could it be? And it is right there.
Even I've seen these videos where they're like, okay, cameras kahan kahan hide kar sakte hain in a hotel room. Like, how could you do that? And now whenever I go to a hotel room, I'm like, okay, where is the camera? These are like,
these
even in a clock or something, they always like show ki And you know, I had ordered for my experiment, the hidden cameras are available online. You know that? I bought it from Amazon. For my experiments, I bought it because I have to monitor mice and everything. But see how easily it is available. Like, you're not even asking You're not asking the person, and these are these size of cameras. How easily it could be hidden anywhere. And that is how our safety gets compromised. So I think government should make rules.
There should be some regulation, our auditing body,
exactly,
which is kind of regulating such videos and कुछ तो करो
exactly.
अभी जैसे मुझे ये भी लगता है, since we are talking about the measures, talking about loosely available things, आपको theft, scams, so many cyber crimes, आप video देखे कर सकते हो.
हाँ, it's so easy.
मतलब मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि मतलब हम क्या ही कर रहे हैं. और इन सब चीजों के बारे में रियली में बात करो और मीडियोकर क्रिंच कंटेंट को बायकॉट करो.
एग्जैक्टली.
मुझे समझ नहीं आता कि लोग एक दूसरे की मिजरीज में खुश क्यों हैं.
हाँ, बिकॉज वही है ना, मेंटालिटी वही है कि लाइक इफ दे आर कम में अगर वो देख रहे हैं तो दे आर वेरी हैप्पी.
आई मीन, राइज हाई, डोंट यू डोंट नीड समबडी एज अ शोल्डर टू क्लाइंब ऑन टू राइज हाई.
एग्जैक्टली. ये मीडियोकर कंटेंट तो
बहुत ज्यादा हो रहा है. आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि मुझे देखो,
एंड यू नो
बट देखो तो अच्छे सोफिस्टिकेटेड कंटेंट देखो.
जेन अल्फाज जो हमारे फैमिली में है, देखते हैं एंड दे वॉच दीज रील्स. उनको तो नहीं पता ना, उनका तो मोल्ड हो जाएगा वैसे ही ब्रेन. देयर पेरेंट्स आर नॉट इवन मॉनिटरिंग
व्हाट दे आर वाचिंग ना. और मैं हमेशा ये कहती हूँ, किड्स को थोड़ा फोन से दूर रखो.
लेट देम बी किड्स यार, लेट देम एंजॉय यार, लेट देम बिहेव. बिकॉज़ आजकल क्या हो गया ना, फोन्स के चक्कर में क्या होता है, पेरेंट्स इतनी जहमत भी नहीं उठा रहे टू इवन सी कि बच्चा देख क्या रहा है. केवल यूट्यूब पे पेरेंटल लॉक लगाना नहीं, आप इंस्टाग्राम पकड़ा रहे हो, अब वो आपकी आईडी चला रहा है, आपको क्या पता वो क्या कंटेंट कंज्यूम कर रहा है. इवन इफ इट्स नॉट एक्सप्लिसिट, बट कंटेंट में भी क्या कंटेंट वॉच कर रहा है.
सही बात.
आई हैव सीन किस जन अल्फा किड्स वॉचिंग रोस्ट वीडियोज एंड एवरीथिंग. सो दे थिंक इट्स ओके टू मेक फन ऑफ पीपल एंड उस एज में व्हेन दिस एंड देयर ऑन किड्स आर वेरी ऑनेस्ट. I've seen them disrespecting and laughing with, like disrespecting their elders and laughing on it because they're seeing the consuming the content of a roaster us age mein when they're like 5 to 6 year old.
So wahi to audience hai sari
bhai,
that's the thing na.
Exactly.
So with this I think enough being said, and my agenda, our agenda together was to raise a voice against women's safety.
Yeah.
Raise an awareness towards women's security. हमें अपनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी खुद लेनी है.
Exactly.
और उसके लिए आपको स्ट्रॉन्ग और आउट लाउड बनना ही पड़ेगा.
ये छोटी छोटी चीजें उसको एड्रेस करना
चाहिए. अभी तो हम इवन वी आर नॉट लाइक इवन लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू हैव अ प्लेटफॉर्म. यू हैव योर ओन प्लेटफॉर्म.
एग्जैक्टली.
टॉक अबाउट इट. You can put it in the comment section as well. अगर ऐसा कुछ भी आपको लगता है, DM करो एक दूसरे के, बात करो उसके बारे में कि आप डरो मत.
Exactly.
Don't be fearful. गलती सबसे होती है, but then if you feel something is not right about certain thing, talk about it. And that would, I think, make a way to lot of loopholes because this is how the society is going to exist for a very long time.
Also, I think when you see an explicit or something like that content, report the idea.
Report the idea.
Just report it. You have that power
at
to report.
At least now.
That's the least you can do. That's the least you can do to yourself.
Yeah, that's true. And with this we can I think go on forever, but already humne ek purana podcast kiya hai aviation related, usko dekho. If you like this, let's uplift each other as a woman. Let's elevate each other and try to share this podcast with a lot of other women out there. And that brings us to an end of this conversation. I hope you did enjoy this conversation. With the closing note, you want to say something?
I was like, okay, if you're women watching it, like we talked about it, voice it out, address the issues. And if you're a man watching it, I think always make sure whenever you're sitting in a social environment, just make sure the female colleagues are comfortable. Not even with you, with other colleagues.
With other colleagues.
That is the least I think we can do for each other.
That, absolutely.
And that will, I
let's
think that will
coexist.
Yeah, I think that will make a change for sure.
For sure, we are not asking for anything else. Yeah. We're just asking for coexistence.
Coexistence.
And equal opportunities, and that's about it. And if you did like this podcast, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Guys, I hope you did enjoy this podcast because the only attempt behind this podcast was to raise an awareness towards women's safety. As you see that it has been compromised on a lot of levels, please share this podcast. Even in the social media field, I feel there are very less women talking about it. So let's talk about it more, raise awareness. And if you like me, then you like me. Don't forget to share it with your friends and family. Lots of love.